In this video, I am going to talk about Shannon information content, which is also called self-information, specifically self-information for an event. What Shannon information content is going to give us is a way to measure how random an event is in terms of bits. To build up to this, I'm going to start with an example where there's no randomness. So suppose I have a number from 0, 1, 2, up to 63. And asks the question, how many bits does it take to store this number? And the answer to that is going to be log base 2 of the number of possibilities here, which is 64. And this is equal to 6 bits. You can think of this as, how many yes-no questions do I have to ask to figure out where I am in this range of values? One way to see what these questions could be is to draw the outcomes 0 up to 63 in a number line like this and do a binary search where the first question we ask is it at least 32? So is it in the top half here? If so, we would recurse and do the binary search in this top half and say, is it at least 48? And suppose it isn't, then we would repeat the binary search in this interval here. And so after asking 6 such questions, then we will figure out exactly which number is being stored. A different interpretation of what is going on is that ahead of time, we don't know which of these 64 values is being stored, and so we just think of them as all equally likely, probability 1 over 64 for each of these. And in that case, the number of bits is log base 2 of 1 divided by the probability of each of these outcomes, which is 1 over 64, okay, which gives 6 bits. So this might seem a bit peculiar. Let me first define what Shannon information content is, and we'll return to a slight variant of this example to build some intuition, okay? In general, for an event A, the Shannon information content is defined as log base 2 of 1 divided by the probability of event A. Okay? So this is Shannon information content. So let's look at a slightly different example. Suppose I still had these 64 different possible values, but I said that 0 occurs with probability 1, and 1 through 63 occur with probability 0. Then we know that deterministically 0 happens, so it should take 0 bits to describe what's going on. We know 0 happens, nothing else is going to happen. You don't have to tell me anything. In that case, note that the Shannon information content of seeing 0, so if the event A is seeing 0, then I'll get log base 2 of 1 divided by the probability of 0 occurring, which is 1. And log base 2 of 1 is 0 bits. Okay? On the other hand, if I saw one of these values, for example, let's look at the Shannon information content of seeing 63. Well, that's log base 2 of 1 divided by 0. Okay, this blows up. This is infinity. And so here, this gives a different way to interpret the Shannon information content, which is as a measure of how surprised we would be. If we saw an event that is impossible, that really there's no way we could see it, we would be infinitely surprised. Whereas if we saw 0, well, we knew that that was going to happen, and so that conveys 0 bits of information. So that's a different way to interpret Shannon information content as a measure of how surprised we would be if we saw a particular event. Note that if PA is large, so for example, the largest it could be is 1, then the number of bits stored is small because we're not going to be particularly surprised, so we don't really gain much in terms of information. Okay? So not in this video, but in a future video, I will talk a little bit more about why this is the number of bits needed to store an event A. So just a note, you can actually have the Shannon information content be a fractional value, like 0.7 bits. And the basic idea is that if you were to rerun the underlying experiment a large number of times, let's say n, then the number of bits that you would need to store on average will be something like n times the Shannon information content bit.